Hi guys, this is Sophia from magischool.com, and in the previous video I showed you how to implement ads conversion tracking without a value. And today I will show you how to add dynamic values to your conversion. So let's dive into it. And to do that, we will need your online shop, your Google Tag Manager account, and also your AdWords account with the conversion we set up last time. So we want to track the price, and to be able to do that, we will need a data layer. So what is this mysterious creature? Well, a data layer is a JavaScript object that takes information from your web page and passes it to the tag manager. And here we have some example with the book category, book title, and book author. And here you can see those values are changing dynamically. In our case, we will need data related to transactions. So we are running the e-commerce store built with WordPress, and this is why we implemented our data layer with the help of the plugin, which is called Google Tag Manager for WordPress. In your case, you might need to install a different plugin, or maybe you would have to ask your developer for help, as you must have a data layer implemented on your web page to be able to grab those values somehow. Okay, then a question: how can we see this data layer? It does not exist directly on the web page, so you cannot see it anywhere here, but it lives in the background. And we can actually check it with the tag manager. If we go to preview, so the debugger is connected to my web page and we must make a test purchase. So here is my confirmation page. And if we go to the debugger, we can see the report. And here, step number 27, this is exactly the event that fires when someone makes a purchase, and this event is created by the plugin. So let's click here, and if we check data layer, we can see the data layer with the values, and here is exactly the value that we need, and this is called revenue, and we can see the price of the product that we bought. So how can we actually grab this value? Because we must do it to modify our tag. So here we have e-commerce object, then we have purchase, action field, revenue. And we will have to use the dot notation to grab this value. If you're not sure how you can do that, I recommend you an extension which is called the data layer checker. So if you click here, you can see our event. And if you click this event, we can find our key, which we can simply copy directly from the extension. And it's e-commerce purchase action field revenue. So let's go to the tag manager and let's create a new variable. So we click new under user defined variables. And this should be a data layer variable. And we simply paste it here. And let's provide a name. So I would say revenue. And let's save it. And we would have to implement also the second variable for our transaction ID to avoid double tracking of purchase. So let's click new. And here, data layer variable. And we can access it the same way as we did with revenue. Right, so this is our transaction ID, and how can we get to it? Right, e-commerce purchase action field ID. Again, if you're not sure, you can use the extension. So if we go here and click our extension, here we have the ID, and we can simply copy this key. And we go to the tag manager and paste it here. And we should also provide a name, and let's save our variable. Awesome. Now we should also create a trigger. As you can see, the data layer is available when this specific event fires. This is why we have to modify our trigger as well. So let's create a new trigger actually, and we can copy this event name here, and let's go to the tag manager and click triggers, new, and here we can choose custom event and paste the name here, and let's provide the name. So let's say purchase adverts, and let's save this trigger. Now we can go to our tag and finally modify it. So let's click our previous conversion here, and we should add our variables to it. So in our case, we need revenue for value and ID for the transaction ID. So here is our old trigger, and we have to change it and add the one that we created with our custom event. Great. So let's save our tag. And now we have to make a test purchase again. So let's click preview. Great, so this is my confirmation page. Let's go to our report and let's see what happens. So tags fired one time, amazing. And let's check number 27 variables. And we can see the revenue and also our transaction ID. So your conversion was implemented correctly. Good job. Now we have to go to the tag manager and of course to publish the container. So let's say adverts purchase with a value, and let's save and publish our container. One more small correction which has to be made. We have to go to the ads account and we have to find our conversion that we implemented last time, and here we click edit settings, value, and instead of don't use a value, we should choose use different values, because we have multiple products that have different prices and we want to track this dynamically. Great. And enter a default value. It can be 0 or 1 so that you can identify if the conversion is not working immediately. And let's click save and done. And if you go to your conversions, this is exactly where you would see your value. So in my case, I don't see it because this conversion is freshly implemented and it takes some time for the conversion to be recorded. Also, it's important to remember that a user must click your ad and then make a purchase. Okay guys, so I hope you managed to implement your dynamic values successfully. And I wish you all happy measuring.
All right, thanks Sophia for these great insights. If you guys wanna see more Google Tag Manager implementation videos, we have one linked up right over here, which should be quite interesting. And from everybody here at Measure School, happy measuring.